Video on cube roots, and this is video number 13, part 3 of 4. I divided the video in four sections. This is third section. Here we would discuss a method of divide and conquer. How do we divide a cube into its factors to result in a cube root of a smaller number? So, okay, this is a Here we would extract out the common factors and find a cube root using the factors. Okay, let's continue here. Let's do next section here. So we would now look through by divide and conquer. How do we compute cube root of a perfect cube using divide and conquer? Let's continue here. So we would do this thing here. First we will note some observations we'll make. If a perfect cube is even, its cube root has to be even. We should be able to extract factors of a 2. Okay, even cube, even cube root. Okay, so example I take is cube of 12 is 1728. That's right in the table. Okay, and that which is equal to 2 times 864, which is equal to 2 times 2 times 432, which is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 216, and this 216 is 6 cubed. Okay, so this is a 2 here, yeah, 2 cubed here, and 6 cubed here. That means that it is equal to, then we keep continuing, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 to 108, and we actually know 6 is a cube root of this thing, but let's continue. So then we continue to some more, 54 here. Yeah, now we say 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 27, cube root of 27 is 3. Let's see what we did here. So is cube root 1728 is from 2 cubed is a 2, another 2 cubed is another 2, and this is 3 cubed. This is 3, it's 12. Okay, so we just did divide and conquer. We just divided them into smaller factors, and then we from each group of 3 factors multiplied together, we pick up one factor, one term in the cube root. So let's continue. Now next observation we make, if perfect cube is divisible by 9, we should be able to extract factors of 3 times 3 times 3. So if a cube root, perfect cube is divisible by 9 or 3, then it should be divisible by 27 also. So an example is 2 3 1 4 9 1 2 5. Let's continue here. So digit sum of 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 1, 2, 5 is 9. That means this number 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 1, 2, 5 is divisible by 9 and also by 3. Okay. So 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 2, 1, 2, 5 is 3 times that number, 7, 7, 1, 6, 3, 7, 5. Then another 3 times 3, another factor, 2, 5, 7, 2, 1, 2, 5. Then another factor, 3 times 3 times 3 times 8, 5, 7, 3, 7, 5. That make cube root of, and okay, the 3, 7, so we is here, we got 3 outside and cube root of 8, 5, 7, and 3, 7, 5. From here, right digit is 5, and from here, left digit is 9. Okay, so cube root is 3 times 95, which is 285. Let's continue here. So cube root of 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 1, 2, 5 is 285. No. Yeah, cube root of 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 1, 2, 5 is 285. Let's do some more observation. If a perfect cube is divisible by 5, we should be able to extract factors of 5. That means the cube root is also divisible by 5. Okay? That's what we're trying to make statement here. Okay? Let's continue here. Example, I take example of cube root of 2460375. So cube is divisible by 5. So let's see what we do here. Then we are trying to extract out at least 5 times 5 times 5 as factors. So that's equal to 5 times 4, 9, 2, 0, 7, 5, which is equal to 5 times 5 times 9, 8, 4, 1, 5. Okay, that's equal to cube root of 5 times 5 times 5 times 1, 9, 6, 8, 3. So that's is equal to 5 times. Then we start taking 3's out over here, because this is a division 1, 9, 6, 8, 3 is divisible by 9 and also by 3. So we start taking 3's out from here. So it's a 5 times cube root of 3 times 3 times 2, 1, 8, 7, 6, 5, 6, 1. When I extract out a factor of 3, I got 2, 1, 8, 7. Then we continue. That's 3 times 3 times 3 times 7, 29. Okay, 7, 29 is a cube of 9. So it's 9 cubed, 7, 29. Let's see what we did here. So it's 3 times 3 times 5 times 3 times okay, 5 here and 1, 3 from here is a, and also CR, cube root of 729, and 729 is 9 times 9 times 9. Okay? So that's equal to 5 times cube root is 5 times 3 times 1, 9. Okay? 15 times 9 is 135. Let's continue here. Some references here. First reference is my teacher's manual 1, which is by Ken Williams, and you can get the PDF form for free and print form for purchase from Vedic Math site, vedicmath.org, which is Vedic Math Academy's site. Let's continue here. Now then, Tirthaji's book, and which is a main reference for the use of polynomials and also by observations. Okay, continue here. Vedic Math for Schools is 3 volumes, has covered most of the topics in Vedic Math. It's a Glover's book, and he uses these books in his school. Let's continue here. And Vanna Singhal's book covers most of the topics in Vedic Math. And then it's a Bhatia's book, and that is has a very quite a few collections of decent examples of the by observations. Okay? Cube root by observation, and that's it.